Hi everyone, Grant for the Flame Learning Channel. A few versions ago, the Flame products were given Python scripting capabilities to automate a variety of tasks. This can help with production pipelines, as well as various functionality within the Flame products. These tools have grown in popularity, and with Flame 2020, a new method of adding custom menu actions has been introduced, and it requires no coding knowledge to enable them in Flame. This means that for those of you creating Python code, can easily share them with other Flame artists. And for those of you who are not Python savvy, can use these scripts simply by copying them into a shared directory. The ideology is very similar to the way the Flame community shares Matchbox shaders, and hopefully this will also apply to Python scripts. We'll cover all you need to know in this video. And if you'd like to follow along, please click the link in the description below to download the sample scripts. Alternatively, if you're watching the video podcast, please type the displayed link in your web browser. Now let's look at how quickly you can get custom menu actions up and running in the Flame products. If you're interested in deeper details, we'll go into it after the first example. So start Flame, and you can be in any project you like. Just ensure that there is media available. Now, if you call up the context menu in any areas of the Flame products, they will have the expected options with the standard installation. To include custom menu actions in the context menus, all you need to do is copy the Python scripts to a specific location. You can use a terminal or a GUI, and it's the same process for Linux or Mac. So here are all the downloaded sample scripts, and you can select and copy them. Now navigate to the following location. /OPT/Autodesk/shared/Python. Just paste the files to this location. This directory will make the sample scripts available to all projects and users on this workstation. Now return back to Flame. If you had not started the application, the next time you launch any of the Flame products, the Python scripts would be scanned, and the custom menu actions will be available in the software. But if Flame is already running, all you need to do is press Ctrl+Shift+P and H. This rescans the Python hooks and makes the custom menu actions available. To verify this is working, call up the context menu over a segment, and you'll see a new custom menu containing two options. These scripts were written for the timeline, and they create markers based on the length of a segment. So if you choose one, a new marker is created matching the duration of the selected segment. As for another example, if you have a Reels group with a certain color, the custom menu action at the bottom of the context menu will create a new reel and use the same color as the Reels group. If you're looking for a more complex multifunction example, you can call up the context menu over the desktop, and this custom menu action will import media, create a new batch group for it, and then cache the motion vectors map in an action node. This can all be done with one click, and you just choose your media through a file browser. Just quit the analysis in order to continue. Finally, while you're here in Batch, calling up the context menu over a node, you have a couple custom menu actions to work with the MUX node in different ways. There is also another custom menu action to cache motion vectors. This will set up the nodes, apply a motion vectors map in action, and cache the motion vectors. Lastly, with nothing selected, the custom menu action in the context menu can add a render node to the flow graph without using the node bin. Now these custom menu actions can help speed up your workflows. But to make things even faster for you, it is possible to assign keyboard shortcuts to each custom menu action. Call up the keyboard shortcuts editor, either through the Flame main menu or press Ctrl+Alt+F8. Click the category header to sort the shortcuts by category. If you scroll the list, you'll eventually get to the Hooks category. This category will appear when Python scripts are available within the Flame products as custom menu actions. So you should be able to identify the various operations, and through the usual process, you can assign a keyboard shortcut and save it to your user profile. You can achieve tons more functionality as well as automation using Python scripting as custom menu actions. With this easy way of adding and sharing Python scripts within the Flame products, it's accessible to everyone. Now, if you're interested in some of the deeper details, please keep watching. The Python scripts were copied into a shared directory, which was /opt/autodesk/shared/python. This is a general shared location, and it means that the scripts will be available as custom menu actions to every supported version of Flame, in every project, and to every user. If you want to limit this openness, you can do this in a number of ways. To limit the sharing to a particular version of Flame, you would copy the scripts to /opt/autodesk/the software version/python. To limit the sharing to a particular project, you would copy the scripts to /opt/autodesk/project/the project name/python. Or to limit the sharing to particular Flame users, you would copy the scripts to /opt/autodesk/user/your username/python. So these are the four options you have to control how scripts are shared in the Flame products. Finally, you do have the ability to force Flame to look in a custom directory or folder in addition to the shared directories. You can enable this by using the dlpythonhookpath variable, followed by the location of the custom directory. This is very useful for those of you who want to centralize the location of the Python hooks for multiple workstations. So that's how you choose when to make custom menu actions available with Flame 2020. Now the last part of this video is for Python scriptwriters. We'll run through a quick breakdown of one of these sample scripts, and if you've already written Python scripts for Flame, it should not be too much extra work. So go ahead and open any of the scripts in your text editor. In this instance, the Python script comprises of three sections. The middle section is the main program, which carries out a series of Python commands and processes. This matches what you may have written for previous versions of Flame. The first section of the script defines the Python hooks that's required for the custom menu actions. This could be the main menu, media hub, timeline, batch, or action. This is mandatory to make the custom menu actions appear in the context menus. You can find all the options in the Flame online documentation under the Python hooks reference. Finally, the last section of the script defines the custom menu action in the context menu. This is where you set the naming as well as the scope, and the names don't have to use Python like these examples. You can call them whatever you want, and make the custom menu actions recognizable to every user when they call up a particular context menu. If you want to try more example scripts as custom menu actions in Flame, please look in /opt/autodesk/your software version/python examples. These examples are part of the Flame products installation. We hope you enjoy using custom menu actions, and please continue to write and share Python scripts and expand on the functionality available in the Flame products. Don't forget to check out the other features, workflows, and enhancements to Flame 2020. Comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Please subscribe to the Flame Learning channel for future videos, and thanks for watching.